Hi, everybody. I'm Mike Cannon. I'm from Tampa, Florida. I've come to this festival for 20-some years now, and here I am on stage.
Finally after
play. Well, I played at the open mic for probably 15 years, but anyway, so I'm going to do a bunch of covers and a couple of originals today. And I'm going to start with the song I was going to start with, which I already forgot what it was. This doesn't bode well. Oh, this is a Michael Smith, Steve Goodman song. Well, I walk up to the mic and then I shake my hips. Take a deep breath and put a sneer on my lips. See me on the street, you wouldn't know my name. Cause imitating Elvis is my claim to fame. So when you see my imitation name and lights, there'll be an imitation good and right in the night. Well, I'm an Elvis imitator, just can't stop imitating Elvis from the bottom to the top. Imitate the way he talks, the way he smiles, the way we start to make the crowd go wild. This imitation Elvis may not be the king, maybe it's the neck of destiny. Singing me Las Vegas in the G.I. blues. Won't you love me tender with my blue suede shoes? Let me be a teddy bear, but you're too much. Oh, babe, please surrender, I need your touch. So if you feel alone, we need a place to dwell. Come on down to Imitation Heart, break hotel, cause I'm an Elvis imitator. Just can't stop imitating Elvis from the bottom to the top. Imitate the way he talks, the way he smiles. No way to stop to make the crowd go wild. This imitation Elvis may not be the king, baby, it's the next thing. Imitation Elvis gonna rock, rock, imitation Elvis. And my goal, let me get back in sequence. High blue haircut and my high heel boots. Imitating Elvis is the only way that I can make it through imitation day. You know this rock and music can't be denied. Just can't stop imitating Elvis from the bottom to the top. Imitate the way he talks, the way he smiles. No way he's got to make the crowd go wild. This imitation Elvis may not be the king, maybe it's the next best thing. Whoa, 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 baby, it's the next best thing. This next song was written in 1908 by some old guys that are dead now.
Old guys that are dead.
Yeah, they're dead. And this song has been done by a lot of people, including Johnny Cash, put this on a couple of albums, I think. Johnny Cash did an album way back, and I think it was something about Nuts. And he played all funny songs, which is that, but Johnny Cash and anyway, this one's called Foolish Questions. It's from 1908. The first recording of it was on a wax cylinder. Well, you all heard the foolish questions, and you no doubt wonder why. Folks will ask you a foolish question and expect a sensible reply. Like when you take your girl some candy, say just after tea. Now the first thing you should do is wrinkle up her nose and say, is that for me? Foolish question. Well, you might as well reply, no, I bought candy for your ma or pa. Well, it's for some other guy. I just wanted you to see it, and now I'm going to take it away. Well, wasn't that a foolish question? You know, you hear of every day. Now then, there's a kind of fella, he's always hanging around your place. And he wants you to take the shaving brush and start to lather up your face. And as you give that razor a preliminary wave, this guy's gonna come up and ask you, sir, you gonna shave? foolish questions. Your answer is, I hope. No, I'm not prepared for shaving. I just love the taste of soap. You know, I kind of like to take a shaving brush, you know. Just kind of paint myself up this way. Now, wasn't that a foolish question? You're going to hear them every day. Now, suppose the elevator person should forget to close the door. And you should tumble down, oh, say, 47 floors. And as you reach the bottom, and you're lying there inert, some fool sticks his head down the elevator shaft and holler, "Are you hurt?" Foolish questions. Your dying words are, "No, I was just in an awful hurry. And the elevator's just been slow. You don't usually save a lot of time, you know, coming down this way." Now, wasn't that a foolish question? You know, you hear them every day. And then there's a fellow who meets you on your way. And he asks you why you're all dressed up and listens while you say that you've just been to the funeral of your dear old Uncle Ned. And as you're standing there wringing out your handkerchief, he'll ask you, "Isn't that dead?" Foolish question. Well, you hang your head and moan. Well, no, I thought he'd have the funeral down and just die a little later on. You know, Ned was always kind of original. I think he would have wanted it that way. Now, wasn't that a foolish question? You know, you hear him every day. I was riding on a bus. It was a cold and breezy day. So I sat down on my newspaper, you know, just to keep the cold away. And this stranger, he came up to me and saw that paper on which I just sat. So he leaned right over and he asked me, says, "Are you reading that?" Foolish question. And so to him I spoke. "Well, as a matter of fact, I am," I said, but he took that as a joke. So I stood up and turned the page and sat back down again. Well, wasn't that a foolish question? You know, you hear them now and then. Foolish question. Well, I'm going to do a couple others too, and I'm not sure the order, but we lost several singers, songwriters this year. And one of them was John Prine. And so this is a song that, it's probably the first John Prine song ever. And it's also the first song I ever heard on WMNF back in 1979. Woke up this morning, put on my slippers. Walked in the kitchen and died. And oh, what a feeling when my soul went through the ceiling and on up into heaven I did rise. When I got there, they didn't say, "Mike, it happened this way. You slipped upon the floor and hit your head." And all the angels say, just before you passed away, these were the very last words that you said. You said, "Please don't bury me down in the cocoa ground. No, I'd rather have them cut me up and pass me all around." Though my brain and her came black and half my eyes, the death can take both my ears if they don't mind the size. Well, give my stomach to Milwaukee if they run out of beer. Throw my socks in cedar box, just get them out of here. Yeah, Venus de Milo can have my arms, look out, I've got your nose. Sell my heart to the junk man and give my love to Rose. But please don't bury me down in the cocoa ground. No, I'd rather have them cut me up and pass me all around. Though my brain and her came black and half my eyes, undersized. Well, give my feet to the footloose, careless, fancy free. Give my knees to the needy, don't pull that stuff on me. Hand me down my walking cane, it's sent to tell a lie. Send my mouth way up south and kiss my ass goodbye. But please don't bury me down in the cocoa ground. No, I'd rather have them cut me up and pass me all around. Though my brain and hurricane might have my eyes, death can take both my ears if they don't mind the size. Yeah, death can take both my ears if they don't mind the size. Next one, it wasn't this year, but I believe last year, we lost Guy Clark. And he wrote hundreds and hundreds of great songs. I had somebody come up and say, well, you know, Guy Clark, he never wrote a bad song. And I said, well, no, that's not true. He probably wrote hundreds and hundreds of bad songs. And then he threw those in the trash. We didn't ever get to hear those ones. But this is a song that he wrote called The Cape. He's 8 years old with a flower sack cape tied all around his neck. He climbed up on the garage, figuring what the heck. He screwed his courage up so tight that the whole thing came unwound. He got a running start and bless his heart, headed for the ground. So he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust the cave. Well, he's all grown up with flour sack cake tied all around his knees. He's full of piss and vinegar. He's busting out the seams. He licked his finger and checked the wind, said it's gonna be do or die. Well, he wasn't scared of nothing, boys. He was pretty sure he could fly. Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath in, always trust the cave. Well, he's old and gray with a flour sack cape tied all around his head. He's still jumping off the garage and will until he's dead. All these years the people said he's acting like a kid. Well, he did not know he could not fly, so he did. Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms, hold your breath, and always trust your faith. Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms, hold your breath, and always trust your faith. Yes, spread your arms, hold your breath. And always trust your game. Alright. Well, another one that we lost just recently was Jerry Jeff Walker. And this is probably his most famous song.
So, this next song was written in 1956 by a fellow named Hurricane Harry. And it's called My Last Meal. And it's about a guy who's about to go to the electric chair. Happy little song about dying. And so...
said I had one more day, one last meal before they carry me away. He said, if we don't got it, we'll go out and get it, because you don't have to go until we get back with you. And I said, I'm giving you two dinosaur eggs so easy, five and
to reason. Mosquito knees and black eyed peas. A little side dish of butter bebop beans. I want a saber tooth, a tiger snake. A whole hip hop as well make. Now go. Get my dinner. Go. Get my dinner. You ain't got it. Go out and get it, cause I ain't going to get back.
This song is another one from 1908. I've been listening to this couple that have been playing. They played a Facebook live stream every night since March 15th. And they do stuff from the late 1800s, early 1900s. They play like multiple instruments. So they play for about 40 minutes every night. It's Meredith Axelrod and Craig Ventresca. And so I got this song from one of their shows, downloaded it. Now, who's out of knocking at this hour chocking to banging on a lady's door? Said Elizabeth Thompson ain't a soul but Jim Johnson. I'll fool him and pretend I don't live here no more. Miss Thompson's a looser and the facts he's a proofer. Trucking little things ain't here. Now, I'm done explaining, so there's no need for me. I'm sorry for to tell you, sir.
So
play a couple of my own songs now. Stuff I wrote. This is a song about growing up in Seminole Heights, where I grew up in Tampa, Florida. It's called Ride, Ride, Ride. When I was a kid, we played outside, climb up the trees if we want to get high. We didn't play games in front of TV, played in the dirt and the grass and the trees. When I was a kid, we played outside, hop on our bikes and ride, ride, ride. Milkman came to each house on the block, butter and milk with cream on the top. You could buy dinner right out on the street when the veggie truck came and apples were our treat. Ice cream bite came spring through fall. Banana nose is coming, was the neighborhood call. Giving our money, he'd give us our order. He'd stop for every kid that had a spare quarter. When I was a kid, we played outside, climb up the trees if we want to get high. Didn't play games in front of TV, played in the dirt and the grass and the trees. If we played outside, we'd hop our bikes and ride, ride, ride. We had the big yard, so all the kids came. Barefoot boys and girls playing games. Baseball and corkball where the bases were wood. Flag and touch football when it had to be good. If we want to get high, we didn't play games in front of the TV, played in the dirt and the grass and the trees. When I was a kid, we played outside, hop on our bikes and ride, ride, ride. TV we had was black and white. Shock Armstrong scared us after midnight. Well, we didn't sit around and watch all day. Mom would run us off, we'd all go outside and play. The mosquito truck came by twice a week. The clean white smoke smelled like kerosene. We'd follow on our bikes and breathe in the haze. When we got home, swim in the rivers, we could swim in the lakes, and the gators didn't bother us much, and neither did the snakes. When I was a kid, we played outside, climb up the trees if we want to get high. Didn't play games in front of TV, played in the dirt and the grass and the trees. When I was a kid, we played outside, hop on our bikes and ride. This is a little bit lighter hearted song that I wrote. I wrote this song at the Florida Folk Festival some years ago. It's a true story. Most of it. Well, I loved the Florida Folk Fest. Though I was a really lucky play and sing. But jamming around the campfire by 6 minutes, I'll be there, a couple songs really don't fit in. Now I want to join the circle. The shout play the perfect campfire song. And every time the chorus comes around, everybody sings along.
gonna write the perfect campfire song, one that anyone can play. Well, it won't have word stops, chords can get in the way. I wanna jam in the circle, I wanna feel like I'm fit. I'm gonna write the perfect campfire song, and foolish questions, you know, you hear them every day. There's another song about Copenhagen Coke, one about a beer run too. The Jehovah's Witness stripper, or the shallow end of the gene pool. I'm gonna write the perfect campfire song, one that anyone can play. Well, it won't have word stops, or chords to get in the way. I wanna jam in the circle.
Shook the gravel loose. I missed the train when I
you think that I've got someone new? Darling, that ain't true. I could never love another woman beside you. Oh, I'm not some doo-doo, yeah, darling, darling. It's gonna drive you insane. Anymore, I'm listening for some big old train, cause I like trains.
Songs like "It Ain't Home Till You Take the Wheels Off," "Living in Aluminum," "You Broke a Trail Apart." I got distracted. Sorry. Baby at the county fair. The smell of cotton candy filled the warm night air. There was a clanking and a cranking. The carnival lights, the back of my legs full of mosquito bites. Well, I was feeling like a county Casanova sort. Had on my Hank Jr. t-shirt and Bermuda shorts. Holly had a blouse that looked sure puff seen. She had pockets hanging out below her cut off jeans. We saw the two-headed horse and the five-legged mule. The man-eating snake on the drain, she was cool. Holly had a snow cone, she was fighting off bees. I had a corn dog smother and velvet cheese. Well, at the end of the midway, at the Spinard booth, there was a man with tattoos and one long yellow tooth. He was working on something I strained hard to see. Holly took a deep breath and held on to me. She said, "Whoa, you don't have to be a rich man to be my mate." She said, "Whoa, you want me to be a custom-made airbrush license plate?" Well, this man was a genius and he was making a move. There was a line all the way to the livestock tent. Everyone was straining and careening their necks to see this county fair paint their Toulouse-Lautrec. But when I looked down at Polly, she was all misty-eyed. Staring at the plates he had hanging up inside. He waited in line until 2:15. Then he looked up and said, "What can I do for you?" Well, when he started that rush, I didn't know what to expect. The air producer had a hypnotic effect. He wasn't squatting and a squinting and a springing the paint. With the eye of the devil and the hand of a saint. When he finished, he held it out there for Polly to see. She gazed for a while and then whimpered with glee. And so in a couple against the sunset scene, was Auntie Love's Polly there in bright lime green. She said, "My mate said, whoa, you want me to be a custom-made airbrush license plate?" They say true love is blind, all beach and sunshine, I'll be wherever you are. Love just got blinder, it's my reminder, the lim color on the bumper of my car. see a lot of airbrush when I drive around. I wonder if there might be some kind of spell in the place. Some black kind of magic in the art that he created. Cause all the women in town, they've been acting kind of strange. My buddies, they're all going through some sort of change. They're calling their wives to let them know where they are. And I don't see their trucks when I drive past the bar. Yeah, Polly, she's been giggling at the least little thing. She's looking at dresses, we haven't picked out a ring. We go for a ride, she got her head on my neck. She's acting weird too, but what the heck she says. Check out Facebook, my Facebook Live music page, my Facebook music page. I do a live show every Sunday night, 9 o'clock, and play for an hour, and just kind of, sometimes I just point at the list and pick out songs that I hate to play.
Let it out the camp anywhere yet?
No, I don't usually play out. I play festivals mostly when I play. So this, and usually I play songs you never heard of by people you never heard of, but today was kind of a little bit of an exception because of all those dig rides that I played. But this song, this last song here that I'm going to do is an Avett song. Call the Smithsonian, I made a discovery. Life ain't forever, and lunch is in free. Bar. I go there a lot, more than I should.